at 10 starts now.
Good evening, I'm Lauren Culber.
And I'm Chad Mira. Thanks for joining us tonight at 10. It's a big week here on KX News. The KX Storm team is preparing you for severe summer weather with Severe Weather Awareness Week.
The best way to stay safe is to be prepared. So all week long, we will be bringing you the facts and information you need to know to stay safe during a severe weather event and show you how to prepare for the worst.
Right now, meteorologist Tom Schrader is joining us to explain how you learn to read the skies. Tom.
Well, meteorologists have a vast array of computers to look at data on, so we can try and figure out the weather for the day. But you may not be near the TV, or maybe you'll be outdoors and you won't see our forecast. So I wanted to show you some things that you can watch for so you can read the sky and help keep you and your family safe. Now, during the summer, we're going to see a lot of convective clouds, the type of clouds that are really tall. They're the tall clouds, taller than they are wide. Now, not all tall clouds will become storms, but when you see something like this, with these type of clouds really getting taller and bigger, keep an eye on them. And if they start getting real big, you'll have a heads up and know that just by looking and reading the sky, a storm may be brewing. Now, you're likely to see a storm that has white streaks down to the ground, and most of us know that that means hail, right? And here it is right here. And you can see all that. Now, what you may not know is if you see a big cloud that the bottom of it's kind of green, that cloud likely has some big hail in it as well. Keep an eye on it. Now, nearly all clouds except cirrus clouds can give you rain, but storms need to be big clouds. So there are some things you need to do to get a general idea when the weather is dangerous. This is a dangerous cloud right there. So is this. But our job at KX is to give you as much advance notice as possible and be here with the information you need to keep you and your family safe and ahead of the storm. And some of those storms can have big hail in them. And Dave Holder has more on understanding hail size. Dave?
Yeah, that's right, Tom. Talking about big clouds, we're talking about big thunderstorm clouds that produce hail. Now, oftentimes we see just little hail, and it doesn't do all that much. It maybe just coats the grass in some white. But when you look at a really strong thunderstorm and a particularly severe thunderstorm, well, that's when we look at bigger hail. Now, hail's created from updrafts, and the stronger the updraft, the more it'll keep the ice in the air and the larger the hailstone gets. And when we're talking about hail size, well, anything over an inch is severe, and that's what can cause damage. But you can see the scale goes way up into the grapefruit and possibly softball-sized hail. Now, with smaller hail, it can do a little bit of damage, maybe a few cracks here and there. But softball-sized hail, well, it can do major damage. In fact, it can total vehicles. So watching the hail size is a key component to severe weather. And it's been said that knowledge is power, but too much of the wrong knowledge can be dangerous.
Yeah, Dave, that's right. This is especially true when it comes with severe weather. Now, myths and urban legends have been around for centuries, and the weather is no different. There's all sorts of myths and legends, but if you don't separate fact from fiction, it could cost you your life.
I'll start with one we've all heard before. It's sunny and dry where I'm at, so I must be safe from lightning. This one seems like common sense, but it's not. Even though you may be dry, lightning has been known to strike areas up to 15 miles away from the storm. They're known as bolts from the blue, and even though they are rare, it can happen.
You could be standing somewhere where the sun is shining on you, it's dry, you can see the storm in the distance, but you feel safe because it seems far enough away. But in reality, lightning can strike quite far away from the thunderstorm itself. And if you're unlucky enough, that could be you.
Myth number two, lightning never strikes the same place twice. This is one of the most dangerous myths out there because despite being wildly believed, it simply is not true. There are known examples of slow-moving thunderstorms with dangerous lightning striking the same location multiple times, like this home in Texas getting struck twice in a matter of minutes. Myth number three, if a tornado is approaching, open your windows to equalize the pressure. Kranz tells me opening your windows has no effect on pressure. It just puts you in greater danger.
That is not safe. There's really no reason to do that whatsoever. In reality, all that's doing is decreasing the amount of time you have to get to your designated storm shelter.
So if you hear something that doesn't quite sound right, do a little homework. It could save your life.
Now, guys, another wildly believed myth is that after a long period of fog in the winter, a big winter storm usually hits about 90 days later. Now, the Weather Service told me that myth gained traction simply because of how foggy it is up here, coupled with the high amounts of winter storm frequency. Chad and Lauren, back to you.
That one I thought was true.
Well, now you know. That's why we got Robert.
Thanks, Robert, and thanks to our KX Storm team. We'll have more from them tomorrow.
And tune into Good Day Dakota tomorrow morning as we continue.